Good afternoon, everyone. Before I start, I would like to thank everyone for being here. When you enter the lobby, you're probably looking at this slide and you're like, well, what does it mean exactly? But this slide kind of shows you the benefits of the CMiC integration that we built out, CMiC Financials for Procore. We're going to take a look and see how cost codes and cost types are synchronized between CMiC and Procore. We'll take a look at vendors, and also we're going to take a look at commitments and such. So I'm going to break out of the PowerPoint slide, and I'm just going to jump into the product right here. So the first thing I want to start with, and because this is a financial synchronization, is to show you a little bit of budget work in CMiC. So the way CMiC is broken down is you can essentially think of the interface I'm using right now as being the project interface. So this is for the folks in the field. The one that I'm going to be showing you in a second, this interface is more of the accounting interface. It's used by the back office, but nonetheless, it's a single database platform, so everything speaks to everything. So what I'm showing you is different views and different workflows of the data. For the folks out there who are not familiar with CMiC, this is by no means a CMiC financial demo. If you're interested, and I highly recommend that you do, is set up a financial demo or a job costing demo or a project demo with our solutions guys, and they will bring you through the nuts and bolts of the CMiC application. But what I wanna do is I wanna go through here and kind of show you quickly how this stuff works. So if you look at the top of the tree view, you'll see I have a project over here, 101 Heath Street. If I pop in over here and I do a little bit of navigation, you'll notice that we have that project over here as well in Procore. So what we're doing is we're synchronizing the data from this project, which is in CMiC, over to this project, which is in Procore. So back to the CMiC perspective. What I want to do is I want to simulate a budget import or maybe a few lines that are added to the budget. So this can be either for a new job or a job that's in execution already. And what I'm going to do is I am going to select this line as well as that guy over here, right? You'll notice that I'm working with line 16 and 17 on my cost import. And more importantly, when I come over here and I take a look at my cost codes and cost types, I'm working with cost code 01741 and 02410. So what I'm going to do is, because this is part of an import from an estimate, or this is where you kind of break down your estimates in terms of generating your budgets and your buyout, I'm going to go ahead, select those two items, and then update my budget. So just going to run through a couple of screens. I'm just going to say, hey, add new rows. There's multiple options on his. And what I want to do is I want to bring in the numbers, I believe, from the estimated cost column. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run proceed. What's happening here behind the scenes is the budget and the job is now being updated. Things are becoming real. Okay. So as I did this operation over on the PM side, what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to quickly copy a cost code here. I'm not going to bore you guys with the details. Going to make that copy. I'm going to come over to the enterprise side of the house and we'll take a look at that cost code and see if it hit our job. So put that in there, run a quick query. There's our cost code that we just brought in. If you guys remember, it was this cost code. The category is B for burden. And also the budget amount was for $7,500. If I remove this and I go back to a non-filtered view and I scroll down here, what you're going to notice is now that my budget number has been uplifted, and it's been uplifted by those lines that I have added. Now what's actually happening in the background, and this is where I have to hop back and forth between systems in order to show you the capabilities of the synchronization that we've built out, is when I come in to the portfolio management section here and we get into the administrative section, I'm going to take a look at the cost codes that are in Procore. And if I was fast enough in doing this, in this abbreviation list, you should not see a cost code for B, which is burden. You'll see a lot of cost codes here, but you should not see one for B, which is burden. Okay. If it's there already, it just meant that it was synchronized. Actually, there it is. It was synchronized with that action that I did by adding that line from the budget to the job. And that's how easy it is in order to drive the synchronization between CMIC and Procore. So as you go through and you're working your job, it doesn't matter what stage your job is in, whether it's a brand new job, it's, you know, just starting execution or closing out, as you update the cost structure within CMIC, those elements of the cost structure become available within the Procore system. Now, the thing that's actually facilitating these data moving back and forth is our PM Exchange cloud product. And I've already logged into PM Exchange. I've already picked the connector that's connecting these two jobs. So this system connects to this system, and that's how it's represented in our PM Exchange layer. But more importantly, what I'm about to show you here is some of the capabilities of PM Exchange. PM Exchange allows you to manage the data that's going in and coming out of your system. So we cannot exchange any data that you do not want us to exchange. You're actually looking at a screen that your administrators are going to be running. This is not a techie screen. This is not anything that's behind the scenes. This is where you go to maintain your PM Exchange objects. So if I take a look at the incoming objects, what you're going to notice, since vendors is a huge part of what I'm about to show you, which is a subcontract creation, I'm just going to drill into the vendor. And what you're going to notice with the PM Exchange layer is we do have the ability to do something that's called translate, and that becomes very important. And what the translation does is the translation says that if there's data coming in to the PM Exchange layer that needs to be translated to a different piece of data before it exits the PM Exchange layer, meaning going from Procore to CMIC or CMIC to Procore, change that data so it's always ready for the target system. And this is what we refer to as data liquidity. So in this example, I am going to bring up the company code, and you can clearly see how this works. It's very simple, but yet very powerful. The company code that this project is linked under, so let me get back to the project view over here in Procore. So we'll select the project, and here's a project. So the company that this project sits in is 20159. The company that this project sits in CMIC, is company 10. And you can clearly see that the translation is in place, that when the company code comes in from Procore and you have to create a commitment in CMIC, we automatically change that company code, in this case, to company 10, so the data for the target system is always correct. And this is the power of PM Exchange. This is what it brings to the game. It allows you to make these dynamic exchanges without having to hard code anything. Now, we do offer another capability where you are allowed to just do pass-throughs. As an example, in the case of vendors, because the vendors are being sent from CMIC to Procore and they're being returned to CMIC, the vendor codes are different. But if you wanted to use vendor codes that are different in either side of the equation, meaning that the vendor codes are different in CMIC than it is in Procore, you're able to map those out in this fashion, like I'm showing you, right? So a lot of cool functionality within the PM Exchange layers. Of course, a payment address, stuff like that, we do pass through. It's not code based. It's not going to break any of the objects in CMIC. And in the case of a region, because you can have different region codes set up in both systems, you do have the ability to map those region codes if you need to map those region codes. Now, as I come back out of that screen, what you're going to notice is that for all of these objects, wherever you see a pencil, that approach applies. You can go ahead and use a one-to-one, meaning that the data is coming in is the same data that's going out, or you can map data, unique data elements, making for a dynamic data exchange. And with that dynamic data exchange, this is how data flows naturally from the CMIC side over to the Procore side. Okay, continuing along there, what I want to do now is just want to drill down a little bit into the Procore application and show you what's happening from the subcontract perspective. So earlier I showed you at the company level, and just let me back up a bit because I think we have a few minutes so I can cover this off for you. If I come over here and I go into the admin screen, what I'm going to bring your attention to are these cost types. All of these cost types that you're looking at within this scope came from a CMIC project. So you have the ability to take any one of these cost types and pull them down into your project along with the cost codes to create that perfect match in order to get your commitments established within CMIC when you broadcast it. The other thing that I want to show you is what's happening on these, what's happening with the vendors. So if I come over here into my directory, what you're going to see is there's a combination of vendors, and some of these vendors have this little banner on it. And what this banner tells you is that this has been synced by the ERP, meaning that these vendors came over from CMIC into Procore. The ones without the banner were probably manually keyed in, but the ones with the banner were synchronized from CMIC to Procore. So we touched on the cost types. We're going to touch on vendors, and now we're going to go down to the project level and touch a little bit on cost codes. Okay. So now that I'm in the project scope, I want to come into commitments. Once I'm within the commitment screen, you do have the standard operations over in the top right. By the way, for you, those of you who have been running Procore or haven't seen this before, these are just the Procore financial screens. And if you need those, you can reach out to Procore. They can probably get you set up with it. But if you're not familiar with these screens, that's probably why, because I'm only focusing on the financial aspects of Procore as it relates to CMIC. So once you're in the commitment screen now, you have the standard operations that are available to you. You can go ahead, you can create a commitment, you can review a commitment and so on. Now, the thing that's very important, and this is where we start talking about the synchronization rules, is the status. And this is huge. So as an example, if I were to bring up this subcontract here, you'll notice that the status is in draft mode. But more importantly, when I pop over here into the schedule of values, there's two lines in the schedule of values. And what's even more important is the cost type or the budget code that you're using here. These are the cost codes that came over from CMIC. So if you were to go out and add one, you can do that. And now you can see the full listing of all the cost codes that came over from CMIC. So at any point in time, you can go ahead and create your subcontract with the appropriate cost code, the appropriate cost type that is going to be sent back to CMIC. How does the synchronization rules work? Very straightforward. The synchronization rules says that you must have at least one line on the schedule of values, which is in the detail section, which we are good with here. And on the general tab, the status must be an approved status. And this is where I was talking to earlier about the dual workflows. So within Procore, you can get all the information that you need, make sure everything is correct. And then once it's correct, you go into edit mode. We change the status from draft to approved. Come down here, press the save button. And now that those two pieces have been satisfied, the status is approved, there's two schedule of values, that information is going to start to flow from Procore over to CMIC. If you have any additional questions or comments, please contact us. In the meantime, thank you. And until we speak again, see you at the next webinar and enjoy your afternoon. Have a great day. Bye now.